Cinema and science have been trying to sniff out a way to give audiences an experience that's as close to the real deal as possible. In fact, they've been using sense with film since the early 1900s, even before sound was introduced. But smell continues to elude pretty much most who've tried to bring it through your screens. So, will we ever be able to get a whiff of George Clooney's cologne through the big screen? If seeing and hearing is believing, then smelling is considered one of the final frontiers in getting a full immersive experience at the cinema. Cue The Scent of Mystery, which came out in 1960 and was written to make use of Smellovision. A theatre was fitted with an elaborate system of pipes which delivered a puff of scents at key moments in the movie. Problem was, the loud hissing of the vents was distracting. Smells arrived to people seated on the balconies too late, and the odours were faint, causing people to sniff loudly. The review, well, I guess you could say Smell-O-Vision stunk, and it's since been rated one of the worst inventions of all time.
So in that sense, it was unsuccessful, definitely. But on the other hand, we're still talking about it, so it was influential.
Fast forward, and smell continues to be a difficult sense to harness.
Basically, the sense of smell, like the sense of taste, is a chemical sense. This is in contrast with visual stimuli, which is energy, so you don't actually need matter coming in contact with receptors.
Which means it's not as simple as turning one smell on and another off with a quick change of scenes.
You're limited by the speed with which gas molecules are going to move, and they need to be swept away when they're replaced by the next smell, and also they're sticky, which is another consideration.
The CSIRO and the University of Technology Sydney conducted a recent study using this machine, which produced different smells in VR helmets to help users get deep into game mode. Those involved reckon something like this could be useful for things like training firefighters in order to simulate the smell of smoke and other chemicals.
If you want to make their training as realistic as possible and as effective as possible, then I think smell could make a real difference there.
Bringing smell to a wider audience remains the tricky part though, and not everyone's been thrown off the scent just yet. Professor Selena Bartlett reckons that the key to perfecting Smell-O-Vision will be in bypassing the nose altogether and going straight to the brain.
So it's not starting with the smell, but it's starting with the brain first.
What Professor Bartlett is talking about is a device that could perhaps teach the brain what a blueberry muffin smells like. And after that's been encoded, when you see a blueberry muffin, the smell part of the brain will conjure up the odour of that delicious treat as if you're smelling it.
We'll be able to encode and understand how millions of people interpret a smell.
Tricking your brain into thinking it's smelling something that's not really there might be a bit too out there for most people. But emulating real-world smells at the pace of a fast-moving action film still faces some real hurdles. Let's face it, no one wants an unpleasant scene in a movie hanging around like a bad smell.